Yo, I'm Martha from Galen Cube, and I've been reading all the comments that you have been leaving on the Purview videos, and you're asking about health management and data quality. Because yes, you can actually run quality scans on your data from Purview to better understand what's the quality of your data, how could you improve it, or from the data consumer perspective, can I use this data for my purpose or not, and what can and can it not be used for? So, you know what? I think we together should create some data quality scans. So I'll put on my data steward hat. And you know what? Enough of all this talking, let's head over to my laptop. So inside the unified catalog of Microsoft Purview, and if you go into health management, you see here that we have data quality. Now, last time we created a GynaCube YouTube channel data governance domain. And if I open this up, you see here that we have three beautiful data products. Now, the very first thing you have to do when you're creating data quality scans in Purview is to create a connection between Purview and the data source you want to run data quality on. Now, this is kind of important because previously we have been connecting Purview and Fabric, and Purview has only gotten access to the metadata. So it's not like we're pulling in the actual physical data. But when you are checking out data quality, obviously you need to give Purview access to the underlying data. So for data quality, we're changing it up a bit, and that's also why we need an additional connection. So let's create a new connection, GynaCube YouTube channel data quality connection towards this domain, and we want it to be connected to Fabric. Now we also have workspace ID and lakehouse ID here. This is for testing purposes only to see if the connection works. And also when you're doing this, we need to use the managed identity as the credential. Now remember I told you we had to give Purview access to the underlying data. So we do that by going into the workspace of where we want to provide access and actually give the managed identity of Purview contributor access to that workspace. Now, if I open up just one of the lakehouses here, I can pull in the workspace ID and the lakehouse ID to test the connection. Yay, it was successful, amazing. Then we submit that and we're ready to create some actual data quality rules and scan on our data product. So last time we created GynaCube YouTube lakehouse that contains a data set. So if I open this one up, we see here that we have the gold fact video stats table that we added from the lakehouse. Now let's run some data quality scans on this data asset specifically. So when I open this up, you see the data quality overview page. And on the right hand side here, you see that I can profile the data. So let's just start by doing that. I want to profile everything. And you can choose the columns that you want to profile, but then let's just click save and run. So while that profiling job is running in the background, let's create some rules. So here you see that we have a set of predefined rules that you can take advantage of. Now I want to check and make sure that we don't have any empty or blank fields for some of the data. So I'll choose that one. And I want to make sure that we have the capture date for all of the videos. So let's create that one. Now, another rule that I think is quite cool is the table lookup one. This makes a lot of sense if you have fact and dimension tables, for instance, and want to make sure that all the IDs you have inside your fact table actually exist in the dimension table, for instance. So let's do that. Let's check that the channel ID actually exists inside a channel dimension table. So I'm actually checking this towards another data product. And then let's click save. You could obviously, of course, change the names and descriptions and so on. And now I also just want to show you that you could also create your custom rule just using expression language. You can be creative with the rules. Don't just lock in on the default ones. Here you can go crazy. And of course, I encourage you to just do that. Now you can create a bunch of rules. Maybe you don't want to have all of them active and on at all times. So let's say that we want to toggle this one off and then only run the empty blank fields. And then we're ready to run the quality scan. Now, if I go back to the overview page of that domain, I can go into manage and then check out monitoring and then see how my rules are performing, if they're running. Now we see all the rules has been completed. What I can now do is to take a look at the actual result of this. So let's open up the dataset. Now you see that we have gotten a score, 91.8. The first run that I did failed, but you could then potentially see the development of the data quality score as time goes by, hopefully motivating your data stewards to improve the score. We can take a look at the profiling and also schema details if we want to specifically see what columns got different types of scores. And you also see that we have a set of actions here. So if I view these, you see that we have actually some data profile outlier values was detected. So if I click on this one, we can see here that we have some outliers on some of the data. Now, this could entail that something is wrong or something should be checked out, and then I can give that a status. So let's say that I'm gonna dive into this. I'll assign it to myself, and then we have a progress set up on this one, and then I can follow up and see how it's going. Now, let's say that this is perfect. You're really happy about all the data quality rules that we created, and we want to have this running on a daily basis or a weekly basis. Then I can go in here and I can decide to schedule scans. I can also set up alerts. So let's say that, for instance, the rule that we created on empty and blank values for the capture date, we're not allowed to have any values that are empty. So let's give that an alert. We also want to get a notification if the scan itself fails. Now, I want Patrick to get this alert because he is, after all, the data product owner. Now, let's choose the scope. So what I want him to get an alert on is video stats table. Now, I could also say that I wanted to bundle this alert with other rules or other assets that I have. And then let's review that. Yes, it makes sense. And then submit. Now he's gonna get an email every time this happens. Now on the left-hand side here, you see I have some more things. We could dive into actions. Now this is a predefined report for us, showing us how we're doing. We have some data quality issues on the things that we've been running now that we should look into. We see that we're missing terms of use on some of our data products. We see that we haven't published the glossary terms on some of our data products and so on. You can see what you can do to improve your unified catalog inside of Purview and what actions your data stewards inside your organization should work on. You also have some predefined reports you could dive into. And then a really cool new thing that's called data observability, which is now in preview. So if you have turned on this feature, you can now see the actual overview of your entire estate, specifically for your domains, and see what products do I have inside of my domain. You can also see how the lineage is between those different domains. And it's super interesting and cool to dive into your assets this way. Now, hopefully this is going to make life easier for Patrick because he's going to get alerts whenever we find some challenges with the data quality. We can monitor it better. And we can see the overview of how we're doing in general. And I, as a data consumer, can see, I think there might be something wrong with that fact table. So that means that I can or cannot use it for my purpose. Now, what do you think? Are you going to check out data quality inside of Purview? Let me know in the comments below. And of course, remember to subscribe to Guy in a Cube and check out all the awesome videos from Adam, Patrick, and myself. And we will see you guys in the next video. Bye.